Thanks for joining us for Matter of Fact. A dose of good news this week about possible vaccines for COVID-19. Moderna joined Pfizer in announcing strong early results from testing. Both vaccines show over 90% effectiveness, and both are on track to seek emergency use authorization from the FDA. With trials moving forward at an unprecedented pace, there are questions about the diversity of test subjects in the vaccine trials. Federal data show infection rates for black and brown people are 2 to 3 times higher than their white peers. Dr. James Hildreth is one of the nation's leading immunologists. He heads the Meharry Medical College in Nashville, the nation's largest private, independent, historically black academic health services center. Dr. James Hildreth, it's so nice to have you back. Thank you for being with me. When we spoke last, you had said that you were going to be a candidate for the vaccine, and also part of that was to help recruit more people of color to this. Has that worked? Has that been the response, do you think? Has it made a difference?
So, Soledad, I think it has made a difference, but to be quite honest, there's still a great deal of apprehension in minority communities about vaccines and medical research generally. That's why I thought it was very important for me to be a participant in the trial so I could advocate for something that I'm doing myself. And the approach is to provide enough information to people that they can make their own decision about whether or not this is something they should do. Pfizer reports that 42% of their participants were from diverse backgrounds. And here in the United States, 10% of the participants were African American. Is not the best, but it's certainly a decent representation of minorities in their study. So I think that getting academic health centers involved and community organizations has made a big difference.
The trial that you're involved with is the Novavax trial, and it's now been fast-tracked. Can you explain what that means exactly?
What that means is that the FDA has set some criteria that if these are met, this vaccine can get expedited review for approval, and it will get an EUA, not an actual approval, but an emergency use authorization. And that is what is happening here. Now, some people who are part of the vaccine approval process would like us to just do the full approval as opposed to EUA, because the standards are a little bit more rigorous. But given the urgency of where we are, I think the EUA route is appropriate. But people need to understand that doesn't mean that there'll be compromises in safety. It will not mean that. It just means that some of the steps that are needed for approval will be expedited.
How does it work between the drug companies? How would you describe that relationship as you're all trying to actually create a vaccine that works?
Well, what has happened is an unprecedented level of collaboration between the drug companies and NIH. So there is competition in the sense that all of them are trying to get their vaccines approved, but the level of cooperation between the drug companies, NIH, and some of the private contract research organizations has been unprecedented.
What are your worries about this vaccine becoming to some degree a political football? Or do you think that when it actually gets to spring, summer 2021, we might be through some of the more contentious political parts of this debate?
Soledad, my fervent hope is that the vaccines will not become politicized, because you know, this is a public health issue, it's not a political issue. And the truth is that the need for the vaccine could not be overstated to get back to a sense of normalcy around the globe. I mean, the people around the world need to get the vaccine. And I think that we need to start planning for that and making provisions for that. So I hope that it won't become politicized, but watching what has happened with masks and some other things, I do worry about that. But I pray and hope that it will not be the case.
Dr. James Hildreth, it's so nice to talk to you, sir. Thank you for your time.
Thank you for having me again, Soledad.